This paper discusses what happens in the high cycle fatigue domain if we have two actin growth channels, shear stress and axial stress, and we compare the response to the in-phase and to the out-of-phase load cases. Papadopoulos expects there will be no change in the response, while Sonsin assumes this will for sure lead to increasing the fatigue life in the case of the out-of-phase loading. The attached figure shows that such conclusion cannot be taken as the final one. There are two distinct families of criteria, which differ in the way they process the stress states on the individual planes. We thought the phase shift effect could be the right choice to determine which of these approaches responds better. Based on our experimental database, we established this test set of 15 pairs of in-phase and out-of-phase load scenarios. Their experimental output is indecisive because both worsening or increasing of the fatigue strength can be observed. The situation didn't change dramatically even when we tried to remove some potential parasitic effects. Technically, we could compare directly the prediction results of individual criteria to this dataset, but it is very small, so the conclusion needn't be universal. We decided to prepare a sensitivity analysis which compares the response of individual fatigue strength criteria to various load conditions and various materials. The difference between the critical plane criteria and integral criteria got obvious, above all for brittle materials. Discussion of the response of various other methods can be found in the paper. By coincidence, all the more credible experimental data items belong to ductile materials, which for most tested criteria show very limited phase shift effect. The final verdict thus could not be stated, and the question remains open for future experimental work. At last, thanks to our sponsors.